So we've talked a lot about LEDs and like how does an LED work on a semiconductor level. We've talked about some of the pros and the cons of the LEDs, and we've also talked about how an individual LED can be dimmed, whether through PWM or through analog current control. So we've discussed all of these things before, but now we want to talk about RGB LEDs and how to use them to produce different colors. So an RGB LED is basically an LED package that can produce almost any color. This is great because it can be used in a lot of different applications such as outdoor decoration lighting, stage lighting designs, home decoration lighting, LED display matrices. They're really cool, so you can use them in a lot of different ways. So RGB LED literally stands for red, green, blue. And so the way you get all of these different colors is by making either the red, the green, the blue brighter or dimmer, however you need to get the exact color you want. In my mind, I think of like when I'm looking over the design guy's shoulders and I see on their screen there's this wheel and it just shows all the rainbow of the color in different areas, and then they just kind of choose what they want from that to get the color they want. You can do the exact same thing with an RGB color. So again, only thing you need to do with this RGB LED is to set the intensity of each leg to combine them together to get the color output that you want. In this case, we're using pulse width modulation to adjust that intensity individually. And the trick here is that our eyes will see that combination of colors instead of the individual colors because the LEDs are very close to each other inside. And when I say the LEDs, that's the funny thing. So an RGB LED is actually simply three LEDs that share either a common cathode or common anode. So as you can see here, there are four leads, and one goes to the red LED, one goes to the green, one goes to the blue, and then in this particular one, it's a common cathode. If you look inside, you can see that the longest lead is actually connected to the base there. It's the biggest piece of the structure inside. So literally an RGB LED is three LEDs stuck together in one particular package. And that makes it really easy because then you don't have to put three LEDs together and hope that that's good enough. And it makes it a little bit more space saving, and having the common cathode or anode, if you get one of those, is really, really helpful. So really briefly, the difference between a common anode versus a common cathode is that in a common anode, the anode pin of the internal LEDs are all connected to the external anode pin, which I don't have an example of that here, but to control each color, you need to apply a low signal or ground to the red, green, and blue pins, and then connect the anode pin to the positive terminal of the power supply, 3 volts, 5 volts, or whatever. In this case, with a common cathode, you have the cathode pin of the internal LEDs are all connected to a single pin. And so to control each color, you need to apply a high signal, or VCC, or VDD, to the red, green, and blue pins, and then connect the anode pin to the negative terminal of the power supply. And that is actually what I have here. So let's look at this really quick. This is my demonstration. All of this, the way it's set up and the code on the Arduino is on our website. JB put this tutorial together, so thank you very much, JB. What I have going on right here is I have some potentiometers, some trimmers right here, that are sending a signal, basically an analog signal, to the ADC of my Arduino. And the ADC is measuring that voltage, and then based on that, on the voltage that I'm giving it, it's changing the duty cycle of the pulse width modulated signal to the RGB LED. So I actually, one of the few things I've done right in my life, I have done the red, green, and blue to control each one of these colors, and it's also associated over here with the trimmers. And again, this being cathode, it is going to be positive voltage right here to the red, green, and blue, and then your common cathode right there that is going to ground. So I'm just gonna show how this is done really quick. You can go over to the red and very easily change it, and you get red. Very nice. Change that over to green, and then blue. Now, this is pretty straightforward. Where it gets complicated and gets interesting is that you can make combinations. Again, colors are not my strong point, so as I was messing with this, I'm sure my kids in elementary school know this, but I had forgotten that red and green make yellow. And so you can change the green if you want it to be a little bit more red, get a bit more of a sunset glow there, and maybe even throw in a bit of blue. I don't know what's gonna happen. It's kind of violet. But as you adjust these, you get basically whatever color you want. So we can turn off the red completely and put up and get a greenish blue color right there. And again, it's one of those things where it's however you need to change it to get the color you want. And when you set this up and you're getting those values and deciding what you need to do, make sure that you take into account the different resistors you have here. So I'm basically doing a big no-no right here, and all of my resistors are the same, even though the red has a much smaller forward voltage drop than the red, the blue and the green. So when you are calculating out what the duty cycle is to get the exact colors you need, make sure that you're also taking into account the resistor value right there, or else you're not gonna get the same brightness and you're not gonna get the same shade you need. So not only the duty cycle is taken into account here of the pulse width modulation, but also the resistor values that you have on each one of these pins. And although I am controlling this specifically with the trimmers, it's something where if you know exactly the colors you want, you can go and see, all right, I know that I need to have 20% duty cycle on this, 70% duty cycle this, and maybe 100% duty cycle on that to get the color I want. And then you can just hard code that into your Arduino or into whatever logic board you have, and it will produce the color you need. So RGBs are really simple. I mean, all it is three LEDs that share a common cathode or a common anode. They're very simple. The code, as you'll see on our website for this Arduino, is very simple to do even this where you can control it. They're fantastic to use in whatever project you want to do. Again, whether that's some small little cube that you're going to put on your desk or you're doing some cool lighting in your house. They're fun to use. They're easy. And they're really cheap. I mean, it's crazy how cheap LEDs have gotten. So highly recommend on your next project putting something in there where you can make it a little bit brighter, shinier, and get exactly what you want. Hope you found this interesting and useful. If you did, leave us a like and subscribe to our channel. We'll catch you next time.